The Panama Canal.
Panama Canal.
Panama Canal.
The Panama Canal.
One of the most vital shipping routes on Earth is facing its greatest challenge in more than a century.
Panama Canal is also suffering from major disruption.
Drought affecting the Panama Canal.
The low water levels at the Panama Canal are actually causing a traffic.
This narrow stretch of water moves billions of dollars in goods every single week, generating nearly $5 billion a year in revenue. But today, it's running out of water. At the height of the crisis in 2024, ships were stuck in week-long queues, waiting for their turn to pass through. Freight costs surged by as much as 400%, sending shockwaves through global trade networks. For the first time since it opened, the world began asking a question no one had seriously considered. What happens if the Panama Canal can no longer do its job? From Mexico and Colombia to a stalled $64 billion mega canal in Nicaragua, countries across the region are racing to build alternatives. This is the $270 billion battle to replace one of the most important trade routes on the planet. When it opened in 1914, the Panama Canal changed the world overnight. Before then, ships traveling between the Atlantic and Pacific Oceans had to journey around the southern tip of South America, a grueling 12,000-kilometer detour that added weeks to every voyage. The canal cut straight through the Isthmus of Panama, creating a shortcut that saved time, fuel, and money on a scale the world had never seen. The project was built between 1904 and 1914 and was one of the most ambitious engineering feats in history. It cost $375 million at the time, equal to roughly $122 billion today. Engineers blasted through mountains, carved through swamps, and moved over 200 million cubic meters of earth to create a navigable waterway connecting two oceans. But it came at a tremendous human cost. Disease, landslides, and dangerous working conditions claimed the lives of nearly 6,000 workers. When the first ship passed through, it immediately became one of the most important and strategic shipping routes on Earth. Today, more than a century later, the canal still plays a central role in global commerce. It carries around 5% of all worldwide maritime trade, with a typical day seeing 36 to 38 ships passing through its locks. In 2024, the Panama Canal Authority earned $4.99 billion in revenue and produced a net profit of $3.45 billion, an 8% increase over the previous year. For Panama, the canal is far more than infrastructure. It's the foundation of the nation's economy and a symbol of its role in connecting the world. At the heart of the canal lies Gatun Lake, a vast artificial reservoir that provides the fresh water needed to raise and lower ships as they travel between oceans. Every single transit drains tens of millions of gallons of water, which then flows out to sea. But in 2024, Gatun Lake fell to its lowest level in 60 years after one of the most severe droughts in modern history. Without enough water, the canal was forced to make drastic cuts. Daily transits were reduced from 36 to 38 ships down to just 24. Large vessels were ordered to carry less cargo to prevent grounding, which dramatically lowered efficiency. The global impact was immediate. Freight rates on certain routes jumped by up to 400% as companies scrambled to find alternative paths or waited weeks for a slot. By mid-2025, heavy rains brought some relief, and water levels have partially recovered. Today, the canal is back up to around 31 to 32 ship transits per day. But strict draft limits remain in place, meaning ships still can't carry their full loads. And with climate change making droughts more frequent and more severe, the long-term stability of the canal is far from secure. For global shipping, this is a crisis. For rival nations, it's an opportunity. Each year, an estimated $270 billion worth of goods flows through the Panama Canal. From American grain and liquefied natural gas to electronics from Asia, it's a vital artery of the global economy. With delays stretching into weeks and costs skyrocketing, other countries now see a once-in-a-lifetime chance to challenge Panama's dominance. The question is no longer whether the world needs an alternative to the Panama Canal. It's who will build it first. Mexico's Interoceanic Corridor. Mexico's plan is among the most advanced. Instead of digging a new canal, Mexico is constructing a 308-kilometer railway, linking the Gulf of Mexico at Coatzacoalcos to the Pacific Ocean at Salina Cruz. The concept is simple. Ships dock on one coast, containers are unloaded and moved by train across Mexico, then reloaded onto other ships on the opposite coast. The project is expected to cost around $7.5 billion and is designed to handle 1.4 million shipping containers annually by 2033. Sections of the line are already operational, and Mexico is aggressively promoting the route as a faster option when Panama becomes congested. However, it comes with a drawback. Unlike a continuous waterway where ships sail straight through, the process of unloading, transferring, and reloading containers adds time and complexity. While it's faster than weeks of waiting outside the canal, it's not a perfect replacement. Colombia's Atlantic Pacific Railway. Further south, Colombia is studying its own rail-based solution. The plan calls for a 240-kilometer railway connecting the Pacific port of Cupica to a point near Turbo on the Atlantic coast. Costing between $7 and $13 billion, it would also tie into Colombia's broader effort to reactivate over 1,800 kilometers of its national rail network. But the project faces serious challenges. The proposed route crosses sensitive rainforests and indigenous lands, raising environmental and social concerns that could take years to resolve. For now, it remains in the feasibility study phase, with no construction yet underway. Nicaragua's mega canal. The most audacious plan comes from Nicaragua. For years, the country dreamed of building a second canal that would rival and surpass Panama's in both size and capacity. The proposed Nicaragua Canal would stretch 278 kilometers, more than three times longer than the Panama Canal, with an estimated cost of $64.5 billion. Its locks were designed to be massive, 510 meters long, 77 meters wide, and 27 meters deep, making them far larger than Panama's and capable of handling the world's biggest container ships. On paper, it was a direct challenge to Panama's dominance, but the project quickly ran into trouble. Its main financial backer, a Chinese billionaire, withdrew support in 2018, leaving the project without the money needed to proceed. Environmentalists also raised alarms. The route would cut directly through Lake Nicaragua, the region's largest freshwater source, threatening ecosystems and displacing tens of thousands of people. Today, the Nicaragua Canal remains stalled. A few access roads and survey markers were built, but construction never truly began. For now, it's a grand vision left to gather dust. There are smaller efforts underway as well. Panama itself is planning a land bridge using rail and trucks to move containers, aiming for a capacity of 5 million units annually by 2045. In Honduras, a new interoceanic railway has been proposed, connecting Amapala on the Pacific to Puerto Castilla on the Caribbean, with support from Chinese investors. Meanwhile, far to the north, climate change is slowly opening up the Northwest Passage. This Arctic route offers the shortest distance between the Pacific and Atlantic Oceans. But it's still seasonal and dangerous, with unpredictable ice conditions making it unsuitable for mainstream shipping, at least for now. Panama isn't sitting still while competitors circle. To secure the canal's future, the Panama Canal Authority has launched a $1.6 billion project to build a new dam on the Indio River. When completed around 2030 or 2031, it will stabilize the water supply and guarantee at least 36 daily transits, even in times of drought. The canal has also tightened its booking system, limiting each customer to one slot per day to reduce congestion and prioritize critical shipments. Its newer locks are more efficient, using 7% less water per transit, a vital saving during dry periods. Despite the challenges, the canal's financial performance remains strong. In 2024, revenue reached nearly $5 billion, with growth expected to continue as shipping adjusts to new realities. For Panama, these investments send a clear message. It intends to defend its role as the world's shortcut between oceans. Mexico's railway is moving forward with a cost of $7.5 billion and a target capacity of 1.4 million containers a year by 2033. Colombia's railway may cost up to $13 billion, but is still in early planning stages. Nicaragua's canal would require a staggering $64.5 billion and remains stalled with no funding in sight. Panama, meanwhile, continues to profit while investing just $1.6 billion to secure its water supply and defend its crown. The race to replace the Panama Canal is heating up, but the winner is far from clear. Will Mexico's rail corridor step up as a reliable alternative? Could Nicaragua revive its bold, unfinished dream? Or will Panama adapt and remain the undisputed leader of global trade? For more than a century, this narrow waterway has been the world's gateway between oceans. Now, as climate pressures mount and competitors emerge, its next chapter will be written, and it could reshape global commerce for decades to come. The world is full of projects so massive and complex they seem impossible until they're built. Which contender do you think has what it takes to reshape global trade forever? Share your thoughts in the comments and join us here on Unthinkable Build